Get this. So, Committee on Oversight and Government Reform will come to order pursuant to Committee Rule 5B and House Rule 11-2H4. The Chair announces that he may postpone further proceedings today on any question of approving any measure or matter or adopting an amendment on which a recorded vote or the yeas and nays are ordered. Without objection, the Chair is authorized to declare a recess at any time. We have a series of bills in a markup today, and our first item for consideration is H.R. 2532, the Easy Savings Act of 2015. The clerk will designate the bill.
H.R. 2532, to amend Title V United States Code to enhance the authority under which federal agencies may pay cash awards to employees for making cost-saving disclosures and for other purposes.
I ask unanimous consent that the bill be considered as read and open for amendment at any point without objection, so ordered. Without objection, I would like to call up an amendment in the nature of a substitute, and then I will recognize myself to give one statement on both the ANS and the underlying bill. Without objection, so ordered. The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment in the nature of a substitute to H.R. 2532, offered by Mr. Chaffetz of Utah.
Thank you. I'd like to now recognize myself for 5 minutes. I want to first thank Chuck Fleischman, our colleague from Tennessee, who's been pursuing this. He's passionate about this, worked hard on this. We do have to work very closely with the Democrats on this. It is my intention to continue to work on both sides of the aisle. I know there are some concerns that Democrats have, and it is my commitment to work with them. What this bill does is provides financial incentives to federal employees who help identify waste, fraud, and abuse and other unnecessary spending. These people are on the front line, and I've always believed that if you align financial incentives, you usually get the result that you want. And so this bill attempts to reward those employees for saving taxpayer money and create that personal incentive to identify wasteful spending and counter the current end-of-the-year rush to exhaust all funds. This happens year after year. It's a natural tendency. They got budget left, and they want to hurry and spend it, and it's just the human nature, I guess, to want to do it. But this use it or lose it is not very good for the taxpayers. And so this bill has been put together. What it says is that 90% of the savings will be directed to deficit reduction, but 10% will be used as cash awards to federal employees. So I think it's a good thing. It includes checks to ensure that agency operations are not compromised when they consider eliminating salaries and expenses and in expense account identified as unnecessary. But I am very supportive of it. We have this amendment in the nature of the substitute, and would encourage its passage as well as the underlying bill. With that, I will yield back and recognize the ranking member.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I oppose this legislation. I agree wholeheartedly with the intent of the bill. When government dollars are wasted, no one benefits. Providing incentives for employees who identify cost savings makes sense when it's done the right way. But this legislation misses the mark. The bill could have unintended consequences that haven't been fully examined by the committee. For example, the bill requires the Inspector General to determine whether funds are being used for the appropriate purpose. This could put the IG in the position of making judgments about program operations and jeopardizing their independence and oversight role. The bill also raises constitutional concerns about Congress's authority to direct spending to authorized programs. Could an agency use this bill to eliminate funding for a program that it deems wasteful, even though Congress has appropriated funds for the program? For example, could the Air Force decide that employees working on the Navy littoral combat ships are surplus, thereby gutting the program without congressional approval? The bill also could create unintended consequences by providing misaligned incentives to employees. For example, employees who work on budgeting could have an incentive to inflate projected salaries and expenses with the prospect of receiving an individual bonus by later identifying a surplus. This could create a conflict of interest for those employees who work on the budget process. The bill also would direct any savings to be returned to the Treasury and used for deficit reduction. That is basically saying to agencies that if they identify savings, we're going to punish them by cutting their budgets. It seems better to me to allow those funds to be reprogrammed for agency use, as would be done for information technology savings in the Managing Government Technology Act the committee will consider later on today. This bill may not even be necessary. We already have laws on the books that award employees for identifying waste, fraud, and abuse, and we have inspectors general with expertise in rooting out waste, fraud, abuse, and mismanagement. But who need Congress to provide resources and funding to carry out that mission? And I should also note that some federal employee representatives also oppose the bill. This bill may be well-intended, but we need to resolve these concerns before enacting a law that could have negative unintended consequences. I strongly support reducing wasteful government spending. I'm happy to work with the chairman to improve this legislation going forward, but I must oppose the bill as it is currently drafted. And, Mr. Chairman, I was very pleased to hear that you say that you would work with us to try to improve the bill, because, I think it's a good bill, but I think we need to make sure that the end result is what we want it to be and not have these unintended possible consequences. So with that, I yield back.
Thank the gentleman. And as I said before, it is my intention to work with you every step of the way on this bill. And I understand your concerns, and we need to work together to try to resolve those. Do any other members wish to speak on the bill or the amendment in the nature of the substitute? Are there any amendments to the amendment in the nature of a substitute? If not, the question is now on the amendment in the nature of the substitute that I have offered. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no.
No.
The opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and the amendment is agreed to. The question is now on the adoption and favorably reporting H.R. 2532 as amended to the House of Representatives. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no.
No.
The opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and the bill is ordered favorably reported. Without objection, the motion to reconsider is laid on the table. Our next item for consideration is H.R. 6004, the Modernizing Government Technology Act of 2016. The clerk will designate the bill.
H.R. 6004, to modernize government information technology and for other purposes.
I ask unanimous consent that the bill be considered as read and open for amendment at any point without objection, so ordered. I'd now like to recognize the sponsor of the bill, the gentleman from Texas, Mr. Hurd, for 5 minutes to explain the legislation.
Mr. Chairman, with the sake of time, I'm going to submit my statement for the record. But before I yield back my time, I would just like to thank the ranking member for his support on this, my Democratic co-sponsor, Mr. Connolly, Mr. Hoyer. A key portion of his bill is included in this legislation, and of course, my ranking member, Ms. Kelly. And you, Mr. Chairman, and to the Majority Leader McCarthy, for making this happen. And before I yield back, I just ask unanimous consent to insert a letter of support from the IT Alliance for the Public Sector.
Without objection, so ordered.
And I would just urge my colleagues to support this measure.
The gentleman will yield to me.
I yield to the chair.
Thank you. This is an impressive group of people that have come together, including Mr. Hoyer of Maryland, Mr. McCarthy, our majority leader, has joined on as a co-sponsor. I want to thank Mr. Liu, Ms. Kelly, Mr. Connolly, and of course the ranking member, Mr. Cummings. I have also joined on to this piece of legislation. It's a good bipartisan piece of legislation. I appreciate the leadership of Mr. Hurd in bringing this bill forward. I now recognize Mr. Cummings.
I also want to applaud Mr. Hurd for your hard work on this. I think it's a very good bill. I want to thank you for your courtesy yesterday of making sure I was aware of everything that was going on here, and I'm very pleased to be supportive. Every day, our nation's cyber networks come under increasingly sophisticated attacks. Those assaults often succeed because federal computer systems are so outdated that they cannot implement network defenses as basic as encryption. When agencies are forced to spend nearly 75% of their information technology budgets merely maintaining legacy computer systems, it becomes almost impossible to fix this problem. Agencies simply can't afford to implement modern technologies like cloud computing that can facilitate secure computer networks and increase our ability to more effectively deliver services to the American people. That is why the Modernizing Government Technology Act of 2016, introduced by my colleagues, Representative Herb and Connolly, is so very, very important. This bipartisan legislation would provide a mechanism for agencies to speed up the process of moving from legacy IT systems to cutting-edge cyber technologies. Under the guidance of an Information Technology Modernization Board that would be created by this Act, the agencies will be able to request additional funds to facilitate modernization efforts. In turn, those funds would be repaid by the savings realized through the use of new, more cost-efficient and effective secure cyber systems. Congress cannot realistically mandate that agencies stop legacy computer systems without offering alternative options. And this bill provides the funding mechanisms to help make those options available. H.R. 6004 is a very important step toward not only helping agencies move the IT systems into the 21st century, but also towards defending our nation's critical cyber infrastructure, in which that I urge passage of the bill.
Thank you.
And yield back.
Thank the gentleman. Do any other members wish to speak on the bill? Are there any amendments to the bill?
Mr. Chairman, I have an amendment.
Clerk will designate the Hurd Amendment.
Amendment to H.R. 6004 offered by Mr. Hurd of Texas. Page 5, beginning on page 11, strike or to transition to information technology systems shared by multiple agencies.
Gentleman from Texas, Mr. Hurd is recognized for 5 minutes to explain the amendment, and without objection, the amendment is considered as read.
Mr. Chairman, the amendment to the bill makes some technical changes. There was several good ideas out there on how to achieve these cost savings, and we've merged those top contenders into one solution. I urge my colleagues to support this amendment, and I also urge my colleagues to support the underlying bill, H.R. 6004. Thank you, and I yield back.
Thank the gentleman. Any other discussion on the amendment?
Mr. Chairman, we support the amendment in the bill.
Thank the gentleman. If there's no other discussion, the question is now on the amendment offered by the gentleman from Texas, Mr. Hurd. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, no. In opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The amendment is agreed to. Are there any other amendments to the bill? If none, the question is now on the adoption and favorably reporting H.R. 6004 as amended to the House of Representatives. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, no. The opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The bill is ordered favorably reported. Without objection, the motion to reconsider is laid on the table. By mutual agreement, working closely with Mr. Cummings, in the interest of time, we're going to move the following bills under a unanimous consent agreement. We have consulted with the minority and have agreed to move these bipartisan bills expeditiously. I ask unanimous consent that the committee favorably report the following bills to the House of Representatives: H.R. 5995, H.R. 6008, H.R. 6009, H.R. 3779, H.R. 5625, H.R. 5920, H.R. 5785, H.R. 5790. I also ask unanimous consent that the committee favorably report the following postal naming bills to the House: H.R. 5150, H.R. 5309, H.R. 5591, H.R. 5676, H.R. 5798, and H.R. 5889. Do any members wish to speak on any of these bills?
Mr. Chairman, you are absolutely right. We support the bills hope that all members will vote favorably.
Thank the gentleman. Any other member wish to speak on any of these bills? We do appreciate the bipartisan work and good work in this committee from so many. Without objection, does any other member wish to speak on the bill? Without objection, the bills are ordered favorably reported to the House. Without objection, pursuant to Clause 2L of House Rule 11, members will have 2 days to submit views on the bills considered today. I ask unanimous consent that the staff be allowed to make necessary technical conforming changes to the bill's order to reported today, subject to the approval of the minority. Hearing no objection, so ordered. There's no further business. Without objection, the committee stands.
Mr. Chairman, just before you do, I just ask unanimous consent to enter a statement on the record.
Absolutely.
I thank the chair.
So ordered. If there's no further business, without objection, the committee stands adjourned.